fighting back into our own.
It's like raping your community.
What's going on in white America? You have some KKK, black men turning on black men. That is fighting the wrong enemy. You both are the primary targets in an oppressive society that sees both of you as a dangerous threat.
We cannot see how what we are doing is the same thing Al Qaeda is doing under a different color flag. And guess what else? If they don't find them some weapons of mass destruction, they're going to do just like the LAPD.
Conference in Africa on racism, which the United States would not participate in because somebody dared to point out the racism which still supports both here and in Israel. I say that dirty word again. Every time you say Israel, Negroes get awfully quiet on you because they scared. Don't be scared. Don't be scared. You don't see the connection between 91101 and the Israeli-Palestinian? Something wrong. You want to buy my glasses?
Ladies and gentlemen, when we behave as adults, we must recognize that our behavior will be visited upon our children, and that our children pay for our misbehavior. As we say, an act does not end at the point of its occurrence. It continues to reverberate into the future and down across the generations. And that's why when you behave in a particular way, you have to think in terms of seven generations from your behavior as to how what you're going to do is going to affect those generations later on. And even though those children may appear to be so-called innocent, they will still pay the price.
White people want to kill us. I want you to understand that. They want to kill you. And it's one idea. And the one idea is how we are going to exterminate white people. Because that, in my estimation, is the only conclusion I have come to. We have to exterminate white people off of the face of the planet to solve this problem. Now, I don't care whether you clap or not, but I'm saying to you, that we need to solve this problem because they are going to kill us. And I will leave on that. So we have to just set up our own system and stop playing and get very serious and not be diverted from coming up with a solution to the problem. And the problem on the planet is white people.
Hatred will only breed more of the same and never results with peace and understanding. What accompanies hate is blindness to truth. In black liberation theology, the specific beliefs in the short is that the white race is represented by the Edomites. Stated in the Bible is a spiritual condition towards these Edomites for being God-haters is that they are a cursed people. This curse imposed upon them for their continued resistance and disturbance to Israel and the Hebrews puts them into this demonized place of no hope for change or salvation. This is where the scripture twisting is used on the highest level and standards by so-called biblical scholars of a new enlightenment. However, this belief in light of true biblical hermeneutics is pure bovine excrement, another gospel, and the very spirit of Antichrist, and one of the three frogs of Revelation. In all reality, the Edomites were not white and can be proven by the Table of Nations, true archaeology, with the understanding of ancient slangs and terms. These are the elements an average person has no contact or knowledge with and depend on honest scholars to impart. This doctrine, just like the neo-Nazi doctrine, only comes back on itself. The true Edomites are the combined races of both Hamitic and Semitic descendants, or black and brown, white not included. The neo-Nazi doctrines of white supremacy, the mark of Cain and the black race, also falls upon itself in the same manner as we will see.
How we are going to exterminate white people, because that, in my estimation, is the only conclusion I have come to. We have to exterminate white people off of the face of the planet to solve this problem. And the problem on the planet is white people.
The only answer to this kind of hatred comes from true wisdom from above, from the true gospel grounded not in hate and exclusivity, to one group, but a gospel of love to whosoever will, based on what God has already done for all of mankind. To receive this perspective, one must accept the very heart of true Christian faith as taught by Jesus, and that is forgiveness. Listen to some of these profound voices of soundness and forgiveness and understanding.
Talking about exterminating white people, I'm like, man, that's crazy. Anytime you're talking about killing somebody or wiping somebody off the face of the earth, that's wrong. It doesn't matter if you're white and you're trying to do it. It doesn't matter if you're black and you're trying to do it. It doesn't matter if you're Japanese. It's one thing that you cannot change, and that's the past. You can't change the past, but what you can change and make better is your future and present. You can change what you're doing now.
You are one evil son of a gun. Brothers like you, who want to wipe out people from the face of the earth, problems we're facing is because of you. Not just white. My mother told me all the horrible things Caucasian people did back in the day. But now let me tell you about this generation, this particular year. People have a choice. Whether you want to be on drugs or not, whether you want to smoke or not, whether you want to be rich or poor, want to stay in school or not, people have a choice. So if you make the wrong choice, don't bitch and complain about it and blame the white man. Don't bitch and complain about it blaming black people. Don't bitch and complain about other races when you don't want to make the bad decision. No, I am not standing by and wiping off white people from the face of the earth. Because let me tell you something. Those very people that you talk about, they died years ago. And dying. Off. People are becoming together. We realizing what we have done wrong. Why can't you look at yourself and see what you're doing wrong? Like what you're doing wrong now is complete genocide. Complete evil. I don't know if I'm looking at you or looking at Hitler with locks. And the chance to say this to you, but you are no different than the KKK. Yet worse. I never seen the KKK come on the news channel or come at a courtroom and yell, we must exterminate all black people from the face of the planet. I see the problem, but the only problem I see is the black man. I thank you. Because they show a lot of black people around here on YouTube that racism do exist in our people.
Here is where we need to see the other side. The open door God was trying to establish was moving much slower than the power revolution reactionaries. It was also silent and invisible, as the way many things are that God does in our lives. The hand of God was again moving through the baser elements of humanity, yet another war, the Vietnam War. This was the first time a fully integrated American military force was created by draftees of all races and classes. However, it is remarkable that most of the draftees were of the middle and underclasses of all races, including whites. This time, many African Americans were already officers and instructors experienced from the Korean War. In the short, this war created what only war can, a common enemy whereby people had to band together to survive. In this war, unlike most others, sides and reasons were not well defined. The main purpose of most troops was to get back alive and not in a body bag. Reliance upon one another was vital for everyone's survival. In this came the same kind of everlasting bonds of all races together. This combat camaraderie was experienced in the most turbulent times in spite of the riots, the hippie, cultural revolution, and the civil rights movement. White veterans also got to experience the unappreciative actions from an unpopular war. Upon returning home, instead of being welcomed, they were spat upon and called baby killers by mostly upper-class hippie generations who got to stay home and were programmed to despise their American heritage by Marxist influence in the colleges. With the camaraderie established from the Vietnam War, another addition that was truly of a healing act of God was when the inspiration of God moved upon a man to trace back his heritage as an African American. Roots by Alex Haley was a miniseries viewed by all Americans. It was well presented and gave hard truths of history in a hard-hitting manner, yet with enough fair grace that it got the attention of all of white America. This was a final call of awareness that led to a truly godly repentance for our ancestors' actions. November of 2008, when just like Joseph, the highest level of office was given to an African American, Barack Hussein Obama. The population of non-Caucasians in America currently combined is about 24%. That means that this day did not arrive by any other means than the fact that has now been made official. 61% of the Caucasian population ignored the dangers of what the man believed, and because of his color, voted him in office. There has been a remorseful desire for the whole world to see that injustice was finally been put to rest in America and that other political aspects to Obama were ignored. I am afraid that the full glory and appreciation of this day was not experienced by all. This is not because he was black. It was because he was a Marxist with a racist past and an Islamic sympathies. It was this blindness of white guilt that certain other global powers were counting on. For the truly open-minded person, armed with the facts, 8 years of President Bush, who claimed to be a born-again Christian, had signed many of our rights away, only setting the precedence for what is happening in the current administration. Many conservative Christians, white and others, had a rude, shocking awakening that salvation was not going to come from a Republican Party with Jesus being a fellow member. We have all been duped by powers that be, powers who want a global socialist America and know how to play ourselves against each other to bring it about. I could no longer rejoice for Obama's election and leadership than I could as a German Jew in the 30s over the inauguration of Hitler, who was made chancellor to what ended a free democracy to what was to become Nazi Germany. There is a political correctness, not to mention how effective black liberation theology seems to have placed itself into American society. It is there, it is dangerous, and it is real.
They put their hand on the so-called white man because the white man went around the whole world and deceived it and told him that he's Jesus, he's God. And they're like, look, he's God, he's doing all this, coming to our country, stealing everything. Yeah, maybe we shouldn't touch him or the Heavenly Father might get mad. No, he's the so-called, he's the devil according to the Bible. And that's why these other nations are coming to their senses, getting nuclear weapons and telling the so-called white man in America what's up. And that's white men come from Esau, which represents wickedness. That's why you got the world off.
Well, you can find statistics on hate crimes defined pertaining to whites on black. You cannot find them for the reverse. I found only one form from a questionable source, and it is not too surprising, but I am sure embellished. Living in the Detroit area, I can concur that there is a purposeful blacking out of this information.
Violent interracial crime, black-white crime. There are about 1 million acts of violent black-white crime any given year. And by violent, I mean rape, murder, robbery with aggravation, manslaughter. About 90% of that involves a black perpetrator, and 90% involves a white victim.
The reality is that black liberation theology has been very effective and has crept right into the Oval Office. Living in the Detroit area, it becomes apparent for me, at least, that the almost like a polar shift of things have changed, or rather reversed itself. Many are nervous about the future in America, not because of a man's color, but from his associations and affiliations and the reality of the changes he wants to make. You are really not too paranoid when you realize that you, meaning all Americans, are the target. This global conspiracy is a biblical truth and not the delusions of ranting of some paranoid. Here is the actual text of Scripture from Revelation that describes a conspiracy that would exist in the last days prior to the second coming of Jesus. While Americans are busy disputing past and contrived sustained divisions between themselves, there is another foreign threat on the rise by the third frog, which very few understand and even fewer is aware of the present dangers. This will be our next topic in the series, Islam, the Religion of Peace, the Third Frog.